Have you ever gone to war? Have you ever been in battle, in the heat of battle? Well, today we are here in the Royal Court of Visionary Studios, and we're going to be talking about growth allies versus growth enemies for your business. Welcome to the Visionary Connection. All right, let's get down to it. Growth allies. Okay, if you are a small business owner, okay, here are some allies. Here are some things that are going to help you to grow your small business. Number one, collective ownership. So as a team, whether it's a team of one and you just take ownership yourself, or whether you have a small team around you, all of the decisions you make, everything that you do, every outcome that occurs and happens, you have collective ownership, okay? Whether it's something great, yes, you want to celebrate it, but you don't want to rest back on it too much. If there's an issue, if there's something that you need to work on, something that did not go as well, something that you need to change, you take ownership, you take responsibility for it. That's going to help you grow. Okay, brand promotion, okay? Again, your company will not grow, your company will not advance, your company will not spread or get deeper if you don't establish a brand. Your brand is who are you? What do you represent when someone sees your logo, when someone hears your name, when someone knows who you are, they know exactly what you're about. That is your brand. Humility, confidence, and competence, okay? These things are extremely important because these make up the character of your company, right? You don't want to be arrogant, oh, we're the best and no one else does this and we're better than all of our competition. No. You don't, that's my opinion. You don't want to come across that way, okay? You might, you know, attract some people, but really you want to have you want to be magnetic, okay? You want people to come to you. You want people to feel comfortable in doing business with you. You want to be confident. And of course, you must be competent. You must know what you are doing for sure, okay? Efficiency. If you're not efficient, you can't get as much done in the certain amount of time that you need to get it done. Guess what? Your company is not going to grow. Your revenue, your bottom line, your top line and your bottom line, neither one of those are going to grow if you're not efficient in what you're doing. That is an ally, okay? So you need. I would highly encourage you to invest, whether it's in systems, people, coaching, training, invest in those things so that your company can be more efficient, get the job done quicker, get it done competently. Focus on the good, okay? Focus on the good. To me, that's extremely important because as business owners, we face all kinds of different challenges. We face all kinds of different anxieties and worries. Check this out. There's a quote from Elon Musk. Elon Musk said a while ago when he was talking to one of his friends about starting and owning a small business, and the quote that his friend gave him said, you know, it's like chewing on glass and looking into the abyss. And I have felt like that sometimes. I'm like, man, I am chewing on glass. I'm looking into an abyss of darkness. Do I really want to do this? Do I just want to go back to a normal job? Being honest with you, do I just want to go back where I can kind of put in my 8 hours, leave the job where it is, not worry about it? I'm gonna be completely open and transparent with you. Sometimes you just have so much worry, so much stress, so much anxiety that you just wanna leave it all together and go back to something that is safe, right? That is something that is safe. But if you are a true entrepreneur, someone who really is pushing and working, that is not a part of your DNA. It's not a part of who, you know, what your makeup is. Look, are you a human being? Am I a human being? Absolutely. Do I ask those questions sometimes? I'm not going to lie. Absolutely, I do. Do I get discouraged? Absolutely. But when I choose to focus on the good, let me give you an example. We just closed a deal about two and a half weeks ago, that was very difficult. Okay, we were helping a family to purchase a home in Manassas, Virginia. We ran into several different difficulties. We had to go to different levels of leadership with this particular bank. Switch banks, came back. We ended up getting it done. I spoke with the buyer, who's a father, you know, family man, as they were going to closing the next day. And he said, Brandon, he's like, I cannot thank you enough for what you've done for me and my family. You stuck in there, you hung in there, you're helping us to purchase our home and to change our lives. And I could just hear the emotion in his voice. And I reminded myself, this is why I do what I do, to help men and women like this. This is why we persevere. This is why we hang in there. If who else would have done that? Maybe someone would have, maybe they wouldn't have. But I can't focus on that. I can focus on what we did for that family to help them change their lives. focusing on the good, it revived me. I'm gonna be honest with you. Like, it gave me that strength and that energy and that renewal that I needed. So I was so happy for that conversation and for many different conversations like that, okay? The client experience, okay? The client experience, that's one of our focuses for 2021, is really enhancing the client experience from start to finish. Making sure that we, number one, communicate with people, but not only when we communicate with them, that we're actually communicating value to them. We're helping them along in the process. We're telling them things that they need to hear, okay? So that they can get from point A to point B as efficiently as possible. Look, so they can get the boxes all together. They can move themselves and their family into the new homes. The kids can run around. Oh, I want that room. Oh, I want that room. That's the whole joy of the home buying process. That's part of the reason why we're here at Visionary Lending. Here's some bonus material for you. Bonus material. You have to have the ability to build and strengthen relationships. Okay, you have to have the ability to build and strengthen relationships. Naturally, personally, I'm more of an introvert. I love to think, I love to analyze, I love to kind of, you know, plan and get stuff done. That's who I am. And I think especially during this, the entire COVID-19 environment, it's really helped for individuals who are introverts to thrive, because you don't got to be out there in people's faces, you know, and all that stuff. But listen, you have to deny yourself. The Bible talks about self-denial. Okay, if you want to have character, what is the definition of discipline and character? It's doing what you don't want to do when you don't want to do it. Okay, so the times when you don't want to go out and you don't want to meet people, the times when you don't want to talk to someone, the time when you don't want to just give and have that exchange and learn, then you have to be able to push beyond that. But you have to also be able to push beyond that with a sincere heart, okay? So why am I talking about this? Because that's a whole part of building relationships. You're not gonna sit down and get to know people, whether it's over the phone, Zoom, or in person, you know, whether it's in the past or at some point in the future. If you're not authentic, if you're not open and real, people will sniff that out in an instant, and you're not really going to build a relationship. But when you're honest and you're sincere about getting to know someone, about wanting to build a business relationship and growing that relationship, expanding that relationship, nurturing, you know, then, and there's the, you're genuine about it, that's a major ally, okay, to helping you grow your business. So hopefully that all makes sense. Now, let's look at the growth enemies, okay? The baddies that want to, you know, just completely decimate your business and make you want to sit in your room and just feel bad about yourself all day. In real estate, late closings, they are the enemy of growth, okay? You don't want to close loans late over and over and over and over again. Why? Because then the perception is that you don't know what you're doing, okay? You can't get the job done. You can't get, not only can you not get the job done, but you can't get it done on time. Not only that, but you don't respect the contract date. You don't respect people's time. You don't respect people's plans. And that's 100% true. You have to remember, in the area, in the profession of real estate, contract dates are not arbitrary. They are there for a reason. Buyers, sellers, agents, title companies, homeowners insurance, everyone works around that date for a reason. We are pros at what we do, so we're going to work around that. Again, but if you're not in the area of real estate, postponements, things being slowed down, postponed for whatever period of time, it's not a good look. I'll be honest with you. It's not a good look. You have to be able to work to get things done early and on or time. Inefficiency. We talked about this earlier, okay? If you're not efficient, you're not getting things done when they need to get done. As a result, your business, this is an enemy of business growth, okay? Not getting things done when they need to get done. Well, what causes that? Well, number one, you're not planning properly. You're not preparing properly. You don't have the proper systems in place. You don't have things mapped out. You haven't really thought it through. Okay, you haven't trained your people, you haven't set the proper expectations. You have to be able to do these things as a small business owner so that you can prepare yourself for success and not let the enemy of growth grow and germinate and kind of get all in there. You don't want that, okay? Poorly defined responsibilities, that's extremely important. Why? Because if you have poorly defined responsibilities, then people don't know what to do. Okay, you have these people doing this and this, that, and the other, and that equals inefficiency. So you want everyone who's in your company, again, whether it's small, if it's only two or three of you, or whether it's larger, Everyone knows exactly what they need to do so that they can do their job to the best of their ability. An unhealthy mindset. So that can mean almost anything. Okay, that can mean almost anything. But really, that unhealthy mindset is the mindset of giving up, is the mindset of not persevering. Or it could also be the mindset where, okay, you're all about, okay, how much money can we make as quickly as possible? When you have that type of mindset, that is a finite mindset, okay? I highly encourage you to go onto YouTube, go on the internet, check out a man named Simon Sinek. Simon Sinek, S-I-N-E-K. I'm not giving him any free promotion, but he talks about playing the infinite game, okay? Playing the infinite game. And I definitely buy into that myself because it's, okay, how can I set my company up so that in perpetuity, we have systems, relationships in place, okay? We have a brand building in place so that this company can just keep going and going and going. We're constantly continuing to fill in the gap, to meet needs, solve problems, continually, right? Undertrained team, we talked about that a little bit before. Make sure that you, your team, everyone is trained in exactly what their job is, what are the industry norms, what are the industry standards and guidelines, being fully trained in that area so that you can be competent in not only with your job, but also sharing and communicating that to whether it's your business clients and partners or the clients directly that you're serving, okay? Oh, one other thing, when it comes to training your team, it helps people's morale, helps their confidence to be up, right? Because they know what they're doing. So when you know what you're doing, you could get it done more quickly, more efficiently, right? Bonus material, okay? Same thing as over here, right? Not sure which way I'm pointing. But if you don't build and strengthen and foster your business relationships and those referral relationships, well, guess what? That's going to make your top line go down, right? You're not going to have the amount of revenue that you need. You're going to see it on a downward slope, right? Money just doesn't come from nowhere. It just doesn't grow from trees, right? Of the old adage. Okay, it comes from business relationships in some form or fashion. Whether you're selling a commodity, you know, or whether you have a service or whether you have a particular product, your relationship is not also always with some big company, right? Your relationship is directly with the consumer. Remember that. Your relationship is with the consumer. So you want the consumer to trust what you are presenting to them. Okay, and so when that decreases, you are on the way out the door. So look, let's end on a positive note here, okay? But I want you to look at both of these items in the back. If you have any, you know, comments or questions or things that I've missed, please put them in the comment section below for sure, okay? But focus on the good. Focus on the good. Why are you doing what you're doing? Who are you serving at the end of the day? Why did you get in business in the first place? What is the end need that you're meeting at the end of the day? When you remember that, when you truly remember your mission, when you truly remember your focus, when you truly remember who's at the other end, who's the end user, who's on the other end of this, why are we helping? That helps to shed light on that and it helps to keep you motivated. It helps that catalyst to keep going, helps your motor to keep going. Right? The you know, the old adage is, well, what is your why? Okay, yeah, no, I get that. Absolutely. But it's also about the who. Who are you helping at the end of the day? What family's life are you changing by doing what you're doing? So hopefully this video was helpful. We love putting out there valuable, substantive content. Happy holidays to you and your family. Please check us out. More on YouTube. Please, please, please subscribe to our channel so that we can continue doing this. Love you guys. See you next time.